So I'd like to start this by saying that I do not believe in killing dogs or killing babies. Really, I was expecting a huge applause there. Apparently everybody here believes in killing dogs or killing babies. No, it's too late for that. But you know, I will say that I'm not gonna judge you. And to be fair, I would say don't judge me because it's clear who the bigger asshole is. But I'll backtrack because a couple months ago, after I did a show here, you know, someone came up to me and they said, hey, you know, that was really great. It was a really fun time. I think Eugene is a great place for comedy. But just so you know, you probably won't be able to talk about killing dogs or killing babies. Wait, what? Wait, why are you telling me this? Why am I hearing this right now? I mean, I was confused at that time. I had to go to the bathroom and check my face, make sure I didn't have a psycho right on or anything. But seriously, what vibe do I give off right now? You know, I mean, it's not a surprise, I'm from New York, so, you know, maybe I give off a lazy, drug dealer vibe. And I accept that. That's a stereotype, that's not who I am. But anyway, the point is, I'd much rather be that guy than be confused for the, you know, the person that everyone doesn't want at their house party. You know, like, oh, whoa, hey, you showed, we got food in the back and drinks in the cooler, and, hey, listen, no dead dogs and babies. And some of you still look kind of offended. You understand that this has nothing to do with you, right? I'm the one who should feel insulted here. I am the one being prejudged as a maniac, you know? And I love dogs. I love babies, too. If I have to choose between saving a dog's life, a baby's life, or anyone in this audience, you guys are fucked. I'm sorry. Next to a dog and a baby, you guys may die unnoticed. You know? I mean, obviously, I'm saving a baby, but I'm gonna have nightmares about shit. Try to save that dog. And I think that's because dogs and babies have this air of innocence about them, you know? Like, you've ever seen these guys in the morning, they're just happy. Happy all the time. That's amazing. That's something to cherish. You can't remember the last time you felt like that. I bet you can recall the last time you got upset, you know, because you woke up. We've all had that really angry, aggressive wake up where it's just like, oh, that's why I feel like if you're an adult, you're not completely angry and bitter at life. You get to look at babies and dogs in this nostalgic way, you know? You feed off their happiness because it makes you happy just to watch. You're like, oh, look at this guy. Look, he just eats, sleeps, and shits. Beautiful, huh? Huh? Other people, they're too angry, they're too bitter at life and everything. They're so angry that they can't even be near happiness. You've seen these people, I'm sure. These are the ones with the permanent, I smell shit look on their face. <You're> like. They come home, everything's a problem. It's like, oh, look. Look at this guy. He just eats, sleeps, and shits. Beautiful, huh? You know, one time, this guy actually told me that he hated puppies. He said, just like this, I hate puppies. Why? What could happen to someone to even be able to say that? That wasn't even the craziest part. Right as he said it, I threw holy water right in his face. And nothing happened. So I guess really, the moral of the story is, if you don't like dogs or babies, you're probably a demon. And for everyone else, holy water does not work. Thank you.